Alright, so today we're going to talk about negative exponents. And this is by Professor G. Alright, so we're talking about negatives, we're talking about exponents, and we end up introducing fractions. So this is one of those things that can confuse students. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so when we're dealing with exponents, we need to remember the rules. Okay. So let's begin with a little review, right? If you're multiplying by the same, remember everything has to be the same base, okay? If you're multiplying by the same base, you add the exponents, right? So for example, if you have x cubed times x squared, that ends up being x to the 3 plus 2, because both of the bases are the same, and you end up with x to the 5th. Alright? So if you multiply by the same base, you add the exponents, then if you divide by the same base, remember, it definitely has to be the same. What do you think you should do? Well, you subtract the exponents. Alright? So, what does that look like, for example? Okay? Well, let's take our same example, but let's make it a division. And so, now what you've got is, you've got x to the 3 minus 2 equals 1. Alright? And so that makes us happy. So the inverse of multiply is divide, and so the inverse of add is subtract. So it's very, very consistent, okay? So now what I want you to notice is the 2 from right here became negative, right? And it was in the denominator, I'm going to abbreviate it denom, it was in the denominator of a fraction. So I want you to keep that in your head, right? Because what we're going to do now is we're going to develop the rules, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take what we do know from algebra and put it on this side. And then I'm going to create my rules for exponents to match over here, okay? And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with x to the 4th over x squared, right? And that's going to be equal to, I'm going to expand this out. I'm going to expand this guy out right here and make him x times x times x times x all over. And then I'm going to expand this guy out, x times x. And I know that anything over itself is just 1, so x over x is just 1, and x over x is just 1, and so that leaves me with x times x is just x squared, which is what we figured we should get. Now, using what I told you above, x to the 4th over x squared could be simplified by x to the 4 minus 2, I'm just going to write it as a subtraction, and 4 minus 2 is 2. And so those two things match. And so what I want to make sure of is that the algebra side matches the exponent side for everything that we do, because math is internally consistent. I can't do it one way and get a different answer and do it correctly another way and get a different answer. Okay, so that's not going to happen. So now let's go ahead and look at x cubed over x squared, right? So expand it out, that's going to be x times x times x all over x times x, right? And so we know that x over x is just 1, x over x is just 1, and I'm left with x. So when I do x cubed over x squared here, basically all I have to do is say x to the 3 minus 2, and 3 minus 2 is just 1, and that means I just have 1 x there, so I can write it just like that. And now I have exactly the same answer, they match, life is good. So my rules are internally consistent. So let's go down by one more again, right? Let's do x squared over x squared. And so x squared over x squared is just x times x over x times x. And x over x is just 1. And x over x is just 1. And 1 times 1 is just 1. Okay. So this is just kind of our a over a rule. So when we come over here and we say x squared over x squared, and that's going to be equal to x to the 2 minus 2, and that becomes x to the 0 power, and I'm trying to figure out what that's going to be equal to. Well, this side over here, the exponent side, has to match the algebra side. So this also has to equal 1, just like we've been doing. So if I can prove it algebraically over here, then it has to be able to be proven exponentially over here. And so there's your 1. And so that's where it comes from. All right? Now let's drop it down one more time, right? Let's say you've got x over x squared. Huh. So that's going to be equal to x over x times x. And so x over x is just 1. And so you have a 1 on the top. And 1 times x is just x on the bottom. So if you've got x over x squared, and remember from up here that x is really x to the first power, I'm going to have x to the first minus the 2. Okay? And so that's going to give you x to the negative 1 power. And so now for the first time I have a negative exponent, and again I'm asking myself, what is that equal to? And again, I have to answer, it's got to be equal to 1 over x, because the exponent side, the way that I do it with the exponents, must match the algebra side over here. And so that's what it is. It's 1 over x. And so that's a match right there. Okay? So, what does a negative exponent mean? Well, it doesn't mean a negative number. It does not make the base negative. Okay, I'm just going to abbreviate it like that. It doesn't make the base negative. That's the biggest misconception I see, all right? It really is the reciprocal of the base. Its position in the fraction, and it just means to make it its reciprocal. It implies a fraction. And we saw that. We saw that there were lots of fractions that we dealt with the negative exponents, all right? And so now in the book, and on the state exit exam, okay, it wants all exponents positive. So how do we do that? How do we make them positive? Okay? Well, what you have to do is, to make positive, move the base to the other side of the fraction bar. Right? It's a reciprocal, so you got to flip it. flip it to the other side of the fraction bar. And so if you have a to the negative 1, which is where a is just for all things, right, is going to be equal to 1 over a, which we saw on the other page. And so this is by definition. Or what if I've actually got it in the denominator down here? What if it's negative down there? Well, what I can actually do is I just flip it to the other side of the fraction bar and I make it positive. What am I making positive? The exponent. I have only made the exponent positive, all right, by flipping it. All right. So again, just a little review. Why is this true? Why do these rules hold? Well, let's do just like we did before, right? Let's do this analytically. And so, if you have 1 over a, remember that anything to the 0 power is 1. We just proved that on the other page, over a. And remember, whenever you're dividing, you subtract. And so you have a to the 0 minus 1, right? Because you can always write a to this power with a little 1 right there. And so then you end up with a to the negative 1, because 0 minus 1 is a. And so that's a little mini proof of that. And so we've just used the rules for exponents to prove that this is true. If you flip it to the other side, that's always going to hold. And so if you've got 1 over a to the negative 1, again, we're going to substitute 1 for anything to the 0 power, all over a to the negative 1, and now I subtract. But I'm subtracting a negative number, and so two negatives make a positive. And remember, I don't have to write the a to the 1 there. I can just write it as a. And so that makes this rule true also. And there's my little mini proof. All right? So this is how you work with negative exponents. Thank you for looking at this, and have a great day.